sea ahora en adelante, ¿no?
Princess Elsa was different. She was born with special powers.
Magical powers that created snow and ice. Anna loved playing with Elsa's magical snow.
Until one night when something horrible happened. Princess Elsa created a giant snow monster!
Whoa, Eric, you're jumping ahead. Okay, let's bring it back. Elsa hit Anna with her powers, freezing Anna's head.
And the king and queen, they rush her to the help of the trolls. Now, if you're not sure what a troll is, consider yourself lucky. They're mischievous creatures with strange magic, and frankly, I never liked them. One of them rolled over my toe. I'm not a fan of the rock and roll. I'm a little bit country.
Lucas, Grandpa V, king of the trolls, fixed on his head, though he removed all memories of magic.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it. But also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy.
They decided to keep Elsa's powers hidden from Anna, and then the saddest thing happened.
No more snowmen.
No more snowmen!
All right, let's not get upset. Let's sing.
Okay, here we go.
Elsa? Do you wanna build a snowman? and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies, and now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you wanna build a snowman? It doesn't have to be a snowman.
No way, Anna.
Okay, bye. Snowman, or ride our bike around the halls. Make some companies overdue. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls. Hang in there, Joan. It gets a little lonely, all these empty rooms, just watching the hours tick by. I'm scared. It's getting stronger.
Getting upset only makes it worse. Calm down.
No, don't touch me. Please. I don't want to hurt you.
See you in 2 weeks. Do you have to go?
You'll be fine, Elsa.
What's happening?
I'll explain it to you later.
Oh, where'd the boat go?
To a farm. With a nice family.
They died?
Yes.
Dead parents? What is this, Bambi?
No.
The Lion King?
No.
Tarzan? No. Cinderella? Snow White? Every other Disney story.
No, it's all very
similar.
Processes differently. But this helps propel Elsa toward her destiny, and it moves our story forward to the best day ever, Coronation Day!
Coronations! Yeah, no, great flowers.
Several years had passed, and it was finally time for Princess Elsa to take the crown.
She stole the crown!
Okay, did you sleep through all of Arendelle History 101?
No, I was hanging out with them.
Well, she was to become Queen of Arendelle.
Yeah, but what about her snowy powers?
Elsa was afraid that her powers would show and she'd be cast out of the kingdom forever.
All the while, Princess Anna, looking as gorgeous as ever. Well, she was dreaming of the possibilities of finally opening the castle doors for the first time in... It's Coronation Day!
It's Coronation Day! It's Coronation Day!
The window is open, so's that door. I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally, they're opening up the gates. There'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange. But wow, am I so ready for this change? 'Cause for the first time,
for long, she does meet someone tall, dark, and dreamy.
Ooh.
Prince Hans of the Southern Isle! Well, yeah, he is my boo. Oh.
That was awesome and disturbing at the same time. I'm sorry, but I don't agree with you. This guy, The horse, is there a skunk on its head? What's up with that?
What's wrong with this? I think you're jealous because he's so dreamy.
You already said that.
Dreamy! Doing that.
Chin, walk away.
Sensual seduction. I'm a fragrance by Aria of Arendelle. Sensual seduction. In a drugstore near you.
That's his up.
Comes with a free lotion. And a sample of a body wash.
As much as I'd like to watch this, I'm going to turn the channel. Look, Ma! No Hans. There you go. Just like that. Don't forget to pick up some Hans sanitizer. It's coronation day. Dignitaries that came from all over Arendelle for the royal coronation.
Elsa was nervous, but she was able to hide her powers long enough to be sworn in as Queen of Arendelle.
And then they partied.
Boots and pants and ice, ice, baby. And there was so much chocolate, the sister's favorite food.
Then it got awkward between them. You know, they never see each other anymore, but they hope maybe that would change.
And then Hans came back and they danced the night away.
Yay, Hans!
Come on, do you love true love?
I do, but this is not true love they just met.
Clearly you've never seen a season premiere of The Bachelor. A wise woman once said, love is an open door.
I would never shut you up.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing. Cause like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you,
I've loved my place.
I see your face.
Crazy, we finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx, jinx again. Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation.
You
and I
were
just meant to be. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye to the pain of the past.
We don't have to feel it anymore.
Love is an open door. Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier? Yes!
Oh, see, Eric, true love!
As Queen Elsa said, and I quote, you can't marry a man you just met.
Well, Princess Anna said, and I quote, you can if it's true love.
Well, it didn't matter because everything was about to change. It had nothing to do with love.
Anna pushed Elsa too far, causing her to accidentally throw ice all over the ballroom.
They called her a witch! And a sorcerer! She even impaled someone!
Mommy!
No, that did not happen.
Told you when you finished.
It's in the bonus features. Check it out, you're old enough now.
Regardless, they were scared.
Not as scared as they just made those children in the second row. Very good. Right, despite Anna's pleadings on the queen, she was really scared. She ran across the fjords of Arendelle, freezing everything in the process.
She froze all of Arendelle, sending our beautiful kingdom into a dark, cold curse.
It was beyond dark and cold. It was frozen! Time to let it go.
Oh my God. No way.
White on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen.
let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
Carrots.
You know, I couldn't help overhearing your story.
I'm sorry. I've had to get this off my chest. It's like I'm looking into a mirror.
In a funhouse?
We're practically twinsies, okay?
And in a Danny DeVito, Arnold Schwarzenegger kind of way?
No, we're not laughing at that. You know what? We'll talk later.
Okay, we can actually talk right now. I noticed you guys didn't mention me in your story at all. I actually did help Anna a lot. Without me, she would never made it to North Mountain.
Oh, come on. We know you helped her because you liked her.
That had nothing to do with it. It was a blizzard. With lots of ice everywhere. Ice still ice. Do you see the problem?
I don't care.
I had to help Anna to save my business.
Come on! I mean, you keep telling yourself that they're bad, but we know the truth, and I work out too.
Okay, I'm gonna get back to Anna.
Here we go.
And find Elsa.
Yeah. Give it up for Kristoff, everybody!
Hey, that's kind of creepy too.
Oh, come on.
Okay, so Princess Anna, along with the help of Sven and Kristoff, started to make the long, cold journey to the North Mountain. They navigated through the dark woods where wolves attack their sled.
Werewolves attack!
Just wolves.
Standard wolves! But they lose Kristoff's newly lacquered sled in the process. It explodes, as sleds are known to do. So they continue on foot.
Then they came across a beautiful glen covered in icicles and snow.
And this is where we meet the true hero of the story. An awesome talking snowman named...
He likes more pugs and summer.
Snowman loves summer. You gotta love this guy. Summer. Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Beasts of Oz, kids of Lodan, the lion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. In my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense, put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a happy snowman. When life gets rough, I like to hold on to my dream of relaxing in the summer sun, just letting off steam. Oh, the sky will be blue, and you guys will be there too. When I finally do what frozen things do in summer.
I'm gonna tell him.
Don't you dare.
In summer.
Yes! Love that snowman.
What a nice voice.
Maybe love summertime.
Yeah, oh, time. We have to hurry and finish the story.
Let's do this.
Okay. The odd quartet of Anna, Olaf, Sven, and Kristoff make it to Elsa's ice castle on the North Mountain.
Elsa tells Anna to go away and freezes her heart.
Accidentally.
By learning of Arendelle's fate.
Then she sends Marshmallow after them. Anna and Kristoff almost die by jumping off a cliff, but luckily the snow softens their fall.
Then we learn that Olaf has no skull or no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
But it was too late. Anna was getting colder by the minute, and his grandpa, he said,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
Oh, that gets me every time.
Oh, we gotta go.
So then, right back to Arendelle to find Hans so he can melt Anna's heart with the true love's kiss. See? True love.
In the meantime, Hans gets a group of guys to try to capture Elsa. Not a cool move, dude.
No, Kristoff gets Anna to Hans, who leads him to kiss Anna and save the day.
Wait. He laughs in her face.
Hans is the bad guy?
Yeah. He leaves Anna in a cold room to freeze to death. Also, we could take over the kingdom.
Hans is the bad guy.
Did you sleep through Arendelle History 101? Get out.
Elsa escapes from her prison and tries to run away across the fjord again. But Hans is in hot pursuit while Olaf comes to Anna's rescue.
He convinces Anna that Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love.
Then back out in the frozen fjord, Anna runs. No, she shambles to Kristoff and she starts to freeze. Then she sees Hans about to kill her sister. She's standing there in the blizzard, torn. Does she save herself or her sister? What to do? Eric, what are you doing?
I'm joining a virtual queue.
Good luck with that. Come on.
Olaf to the rescue! Yeah, first he takes out Hans's little sticky hands, and then he kisses Anna.
Wait,
that's
what?
Right, the talking snowman is the act of true love that can thaw a frozen heart and everybody lives happily ever after. Because some people,
are worth melting for. The end! Thank you!
It's gonna go away. Oh, hello, Anna.
Hi.
Hi, Kristoff.
Oh, hello again.
Anna, have you found your sister yet?
Well, we're still kind of looking for her.
Well, what's going on here?
It's getting cold in here, and that can only mean one thing.
Oh, I hope so! Then we can really celebrate the Carousel Festival!
Of Arendelle. Oh, she's so great! We're just happy.